All right, sorry, I got cut off. My minutes ran out and I had to delete it. Right, so I'll read the last verse again. Right. Notwithstanding, she shall be saved in childbearing if they continue in faith and charity and holiness with sobriety. Even if you're married to a woman, you're still considered holy.
Right.
Again. And not unholy. Now, Paul, though, says something different in Romans, right? Chapter 5, verse 12. Wherefore, as by one man, sin entered into the world, and death by sin. And so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned. For until the law, sin was in the world, but sin is not imputed where there is no law. The commandment was not to eat of the tree, so if you ate of the tree, you would die. Nevertheless, death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over them that had not sinned after the similitude of Adam's transgression, who is the figure of him that is to come. But not as the offense, so also is the free gift. For if through the offense of one many be dead, much more the grace of God and the gift by grace, which is by one man, Jesus Christ, hath abounded unto men. Many. Right? Again, you hear the word many.
Right.
And not as it may by one that sinned, so is the gift, for the judgment was by one to condemnation. But the free gift is of many offenses unto justification. For if by one man's offense death reigned by one, much more they which received abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one, Jesus Christ. Therefore, as by the offense of one, judgment came upon all men and women, by the way. Just cause Paul uses the men word, right? It don't mean women don't die too. Idiot. Who am I talking to? To condemnation. Even so, by the righteousness of one, the free gift upon all men unto justification of life. For by one man's disobedience, many, again, were made sinners.
Right.
So by the obedience of one, shall many be made righteous. See, Christ did everything in the scriptures he was allowed to do as the Messiah.
Right.
Even maybe have sex with seven women.
Right.
Seven women shall take hold of one man. Isaiah said that of somebody, and it wasn't him. He only had one wife. Right. David had 17, Solomon 1,000, but he's talking about seven women with one man.
Right.
And then John talks of the seven churches, and Jesus Christ is in the middle of the seven churches with a golden girdle girt about his paps, female breasts. Showing how he's one with the male and the female.
Mm-hmm.
He is the first and the last, who was formed first. Adam, then Eve. That means he was formed last of all.
Okay.
And Jesus said, I am the first and the last.
Right.
Not the first in pretending to be the last.
Right.
Or the first with the last only. But the first and the last, even in Isaiah, which is where John got that from.
Right.
He also got the seven seals from Isaiah 29.
Right.
And you don't want to listen. And who can make you? Jesus didn't come here to force you to accept salvation. It's a choice. And really what you're doing is you're playing dumb.
Right.
So Paul also said that a woman cannot teach or have authority over the man, but the Old Testament don't show that.
Right.
And the Old Testament was carnal.
Right.
We still died and only Jesus was raised from the dead.
Right.
Even till now.
Right.
Only Jesus was raised from the dead.
Right.
Every other man dies. Every other woman dies.
Right.
And we are all one in the body of Jesus.
Right.
We be many are one in his body.
Right.
You won't hear that. And it's my job as a man of God, even if you don't understand it, to try to explain it to you. Whether you understand it like I do or not,
right?
And what John is also saying is I'm fighting an uphill battle because you let Constantine take over the church with the Orthodox who focus only on the men.
Right.
Like the world is only filled with men.
Right.
And not men and women.
Right.
That is the carnal mind, which is enmity against the Spirit of God, who is in all flesh.
Right.
You don't think God is equally in the vessel of the female as well as the male? And that's why we're one body in Christ who died for the sins of the world.
Right.
Or the sin of the world in John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that again, whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Right.
So again, whosoever means male or female still. Even if he goes to the masculine gender.
Right.
Because the male is considered the head of the female.
Mm-hmm.
But Christ is the head of every man.
Right.
And God is the head of Christ. But that's also because his body includes the female. Partially.
Right.
Or he couldn't have had paps in Revelations 1:13.
Right.
And men are lying about it from Constantine till now.
Mm-hmm.
You're trying to reseal the seals the disciples opened.
Right.
About the male and female being one in the body of Christ. And all I can do is try to tell you that.
Right.
I can't make you believe me. But I'm supposed to say it anyway. Because it's the truth.
Right.
Whether you like it or not, I'm to tell you the truth.
Right.
And this is all I can tell you, that if you're lying about something and doing something the Bible tells you not to do, you're wrong.
Right.
But you do have grace upon your life, even when you sin.
Right.
God can forgive you, though you also have to repent of that sin. That's always been the message.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Now, I don't condemn sexual sins. Neither did God condemn what Adam and Eve did with Satan in Eden through the serpent anyway. Lying to them and getting them to eat of the wrong tree. The tree they weren't supposed to eat of. And men are trees too.
Right.
You're just playing dumb. Now, if you want to play the dummy,
right,
you're the one playing the dummy. No one can stop you from playing the dummy.
Right.
But like Satan, you're going to die and go to hell with him.
Right.
Or you die and go to paradise with Jesus.
Right.
That's your options,
right?
And I'm not to judge anybody for anything you commit, because you can repent even in the future, and I'm not to condemn you for your mistakes that you're making now, even if you were molesting children yourself.
Right.
Or you let a 4-year-old wake up a 24-year-old trying to go to sleep on the couch. That ain't normal either.
Right.
To have to deal with when you're trying to go to sleep.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So you're trying to accuse me of something that only my ex-wife would know, and only if I brought her daughter back in there to her. Unless she was trying to let her go to the bathroom and just standing in the doorway. Which don't make sense. Right? And I didn't see her when the girl was interacting with me. If she were to. Again, making up a hypothetical situation doesn't mean it happened or not,
right?
Only that it could have happened,
right?
And all this happened before a lot of these shows were on the air, except for Oprah. Oprah's been on since the 80s,
right?
And Phil Donahue was on before that,
right?
So what you want to do,
right?
Lie or tell the truth,
right?
And can you tell the truth? If you let men trick you, men can trick you into a lie. Being that they're carnally minded,
right?